We are the living dead. All people die once, but we taste the bitterness of death many times a day. This is how a political prisoner described his detention in Egypt's infamous Scorpion prison in a letter smuggled in 2015. 4 years later, the condition of prisons in Egypt are not getting any better. Tens of thousands of political prisoners are detained in inhumane conditions, just like Mohamed Morsi was, and their suffering is often underreported.
يوم يحسوا إنه أنت خلاص جبت آخرك وممكن تموت في إيديهم يبدأوا يعالجوك وأحيانا كان في حالات بتموت منهم يعني من كثر التعذيب ما يقدروش يلحقوها يعني.
This leaked video shows how detainees live. Up to 80 people can be crammed in a prison cell like this with little sanitation, space, and no medical care. Many prisoners get sick and existing medical conditions are aggravated. The handling of medical care by Egyptian authorities has been called a policy of slow death. Former presidential candidate Abdelmoneim Aboulfouatou, who was arrested last year, has been denied adequate medical care. His family reported that Aboulfouatou has suffered from 4 heart attacks since his incarceration, but prison authorities refused to take him to the hospital. Aboulfouatou was arrested in February 2018 on charges related to leading a terrorist organization and spreading false news, a common charge that has sent Sisi's political opponents behind bars. According to Human Rights Watch, 60,000 people have been imprisoned on politically motivated charges since Sisi took office after the military coup of 2012. The list includes politicians, activists, peaceful protesters, and even comedians. Many of them were at the front lines of the 2011 revolution. 8 years later, Egyptian courts have issued more than 2,500 death sentences in alleged political violence cases, making the country among the top executioners in the world. Egyptian authorities often deny political prisoners family visits and even access to lawyers. Yet Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi continually denies having political prisoners.
We don't have political prisoners, nor prisoners of opinion. We are trying to stand against extremists who impose their ideology on the people. Now they are subject to a fair trial, and it may take years.
The Egyptian regime has built dozens of new prisons since the coup, but the notorious Burj Al Arab prison in Alexandria and the Scorpion prison in Cairo remain the biggest. Both prisons are known for torture and inhumane conditions. In 2016, prison authorities raided the cells in Burj Al Arab, injuring dozens. The political prisoners were protesting the intimidation and threats they received from a prison officer. Officers threw tear gas canisters at inmates and also shot rubber-coated bullets, injuring many. Their families were protesting outside. Hundreds of political prisoners were later moved to different prisons, a common reprisal tactic to keep detainees away from their families. Families of the prisoners have reported many cases of abuse and retaliatory measures taken by Egyptian authorities against the political prisoners. Even though the families of the prisoners have sent thousands of letters to Egypt's public prosecutors reporting prison abuse, their demands have received little attention from the authorities. Scorpion Prison, dubbed by activists as Egypt's Guantanamo, is shrouded in secrecy.
What happens in Scorpion is often quite secret because the government regularly bans families and lawyers from visiting the prison.
This is what one inmate said about his unfair treatment in Scorpion Prison. ...762 detainees have died in Egyptian prisons since the 2013 coup. 551 of them died as a result of medical negligence.